Blog Talk Radio.
Okay. Number one, the universities are going to experience a move of God that's going to bring the fear of the Lord.
Wow!
And that got off the bread. Okay. Number two, people that have been crying out, and listen to me, for the anointing to fall on them. God is getting ready to anoint an army that is going to be so powerful to move in signs and wonders. It's going to be the supermarket. It's going to be a Walmart. It's going to be McDonald's. It's going to be Target. I mean, everyone. I mean, God is getting ready to move. Now, I want to say something that's going to happen with this. The pressure that is going to put our society is actually going to enrage Satan. And so there's going to be this persecution bridge, you know, that you talked about. But what is going to happen is that if they continue to persecute the church and the singers who will stand up and not be ashamed and not be in political correctness, those networks, those media outlets are going to fall down. And the Lord is raising up an alternative voice that is media revolutionary. I'm telling you, the Spirit of God, there's going to be YouTube revival. There's going to be social networking, new ideas. There's going to be these media revolutionaries are going to take away the wealth of these liberal networks that have dared touch the apple of God's eye.
Spiritual Revolution Radio here with your host and moderator this evening, along with our co-host, the Honorable Apostle Carlos Rosa from Lying on the Word Ministries International there in Anchorage, Alaska. You can call us in right now at 929-477-3997. Again, beloved, you can call us in right now at 929-477-3997. If you live outside of the continental United States of America, you can call us in right now at 001, then 929-477-3997. Again, that is 001, then 929-477-3997. Now, beloved, you can listen to us on iTunes.com, iHeartRadio.com, SoundCloud.com, Spreaker.com, / Global Spiritual Revolution Radio. You can also listen to us on Sunday mornings at 10 a.m. beginning this coming Sunday morning at Red Nation Rising Radio. Again, at Red Nation Rising Radio there in Dallas, Texas. And also you can listen to this podcast as well, not just tonight, but also on this coming Sunday evening on TalkStreamLive.com. We are so honored and so privileged to have with us, and I have to say with the utmost humility, we have not just a preacher, we have not just a pastor, we have a global apostolic leader, a global apostolic revolutionary. We have not a woman apostle, but we have an apostle who is walking according to apostolic succession, carrying the end time anointing of the original 12 apostles. And I am so honored, and we are just so honored and grateful here as a global international ministry here at Global Spiritual Revolution Radio here in New York City, New York. Amen. And to all of our Global Revolution partners who are listening right now in 125 countries around the world, this great woman of God needs no introduction. She needs no introduction. She is a true apostle of the Lord Jesus Christ. And I present to some and introduce to others the Honorable Apostle Dr. Cindy Jacob. She is the co-founder of Generals International, and she is also the co-founder of the Reformation Prayer Network there in Red Oak, Texas. Amen. She is also the presiding apostle of the Apostolic Council of Prophetic Elders, also out of Dallas, Texas. Amen. She's also the founder of the Deborah Company there in Dallas, Texas. She has traveled around the world fulfilling the call of the Lord upon her life, amen, to go into all the world and to preach the gospel to every creature, amen. And she has been traveling, amen, for the past 30-some years. She has apostolically ministered to more than 100 nations around the world. She is an award-winning author, amen. She is going to talk about her latest book as well, amen. She is a frequent guest on the Trinity Broadcasting Network, the 700 Club, and with this great woman of God, along with her powerful husband, the Honorable Mike, amen, Jacobs, they co-host, amen, a television program entitled God Knows, which is a weekly television show that has aired to a potential audience of 800 million people. Listen, saints, this is not just a regular preacher. This is an apostle who speaks to kings, to queens, to magistrates, to potentates, to heads of government. And Apostle Cindy Jacobs, it is such an honor for us here at Global Spiritual Revolution that you could take time out of your busy schedule to impart into us tonight, amen, remaking America in the image of God. God bless you, woman of God.
Well, thank you, and just greetings to all the listeners around the world. It's very exciting to be family together. And exciting to have God give us a now word of what he's saying today. Thank you so much, Bishop.
Thank you. All right, 929-477-3997. The board is lighting up like crazy. We also have new Revolution partners out of Dublin, Ireland, who are listening right now online on Global Spiritual Revolution Radio. We have new Revolution partners out of Birmingham, England, out of the country of Wales. Also, for the very first time, we have Revolution partners listening to us out of the nation of Malaysia, and also out of Jakarta, Indonesia. Apostle, can you lead us into the word of God through prayer? Can you lead us into the mind of God in prayer as we set the spiritual scene for tonight's broadcast?
Amen. Well, Father, we thank you. You're a great and mighty God, and you're an all-knowing God. You know the end from the beginning. You know everything, every breath we take. And, Father, I thank you that you also are the one who is the king of the nations. So, Father, we thank you for all of these nations standing in agreement together right now around your throne. Father, we thank you for many of those that are listening that are in of themselves reformers, in of themselves spiritual awakeners. And I just feel from the Lord that the Lord is saying to me that there's some of you that are listening that you have just been so hungry. You feel like you live in a wilderness and you're not getting some of that word you need. But the Lord is just showing me that God is getting ready to open tremendous doors even in many of your nations, that God is getting ready to shake the nations for good, bring reformation, bring massive change. And so, you know, you might be under huge attack right now. You might be going through some real difficult, dark days, but the Lord says it's always darkest before the dawn. And the Lord just says, you just keep pressing through this time because you're going to see a tremendous breakthrough.
In Jesus' mighty name, 929-477-3997. And to all of our listeners and to all our Revolution partners, if you have your speaker on, either on your cell phone or your landline phone, please turn off your speakers because we want to hear what God has for us tonight through a voice, not just a voice, but the voice that God has called in this 21st century. Apostle Jacobs, you need no introduction. What is the Lord showing you as we are remaking America in the image of God? It seems like, woman of God, that Satan is trying to push a demonic agenda. Instead of remaking America in the image of God, Satan is trying to push the agenda of remaking God in the image of America. Why are we seeing so much rebellion because of this new president that we elected into office a few months ago?
Well, I mean, there's a multi-level question, kind of, you said. The Lord just gave me a vision, which we're just putting out, and the Lord spoke to me, it's swamp wars. And I said, well, what does that mean, Lord? And he said to me, well, as things are, you know, corruption is being, you know, we call it drain the swamp, you know, and all these things, you know, are starting to be dealt with. Well, it's exposing the poisonous snakes and the crocodiles and whatever that are in the swamp. And the Lord spoke to me and he said, it's war. And he said, it's going to get ugly. It's going to get uglier. But don't look at it as a bad sign. Look at it as a good sign. And I actually saw these creatures like turning on each other and starting to devour one another because there was just so little water left, so little place to hide in that swamp. So, you know, I and this is the other picture I got. You know, Bishop, as you were just asking me that question, and what the picture I saw is of a three-year-old having a tantrum. And what I mean by this is that when God starts putting restraints on a nation, there are people that are going to have temper tantrums. There are people that are going to say, you know, I'm not going to come under restraint. I'm going to abort babies when I want, they might say. Or, you know, I want to do what I want with my life. You know, there should be no godly restraints. And what we're seeing is kind of, you know, a huge temper tantrum of some of those who've been in that state of rebellion. Now, it's not to say this administration is perfect, but I always say you get the president you pray for. You get the Congress you pray for. Yeah. Or some of you in other nations, you have parliaments, but you understand what I'm saying.
Yes. This is powerful. 929-477-3997. What is the Lord showing you, Apostle, concerning the coming apostolic reformation and the radical changes within our government through the Trump administration? What is the Lord showing you now, apostolically, prophetically, as God is unveiling this apostolic reformation and these radical changes that President Trump is to bring?
Well, first of all, prophetically, this is 500 years since the Reformation of Martin Luther, October 31st, 2017. And so we have to understand God is into times and seasons. So concerning what's happening now, we are moving into a time of tremendous reformation that the Lord is doing and will do if we pray through this administration. And, you know, and I want to say including immigration reform, because a lot of people are very upset about that. And so, you know, this is God's hour. I mean, I'm sure many of you know, and I said this on Sid Roth's program recently, Then when Donald Trump was inaugurated, he was 70 years old, 70 years, 7 months, and 7 days old. And in the Hebrew calendar, this is year 5777. And even now, just today, some of you I know are listening in different time zones, but we're hearing the testimony of a pro-life Supreme Court judge, which is outstanding because, you know, on a number of levels, we've been under religious persecution, and the Lord has, you know, just shown us that this is going to shift everything, you know, the beginning of this shift, and raise up reformers. Well, somebody was writing me the other day and said that Gorsuch, who is the Supreme Court pick who they're, you know, is testifying before Congress about being a judge, had written like 777 opinions, you know, in his time on the court. So, again, in the Hebrew year 5777, the symbolism of that is a crown sword, meaning that God, with his sword, is cutting away. He's cutting away corruption. He's cutting away lies. You know, he's cutting away, as it was, the underbrush, so that we can really see the main things that need to happen. In fact, I even prophesied something radical, that even God was going to show us a plan how to balance the budget, which, I mean, what do we have, $21-23 trillion in debt? I mean, the average citizen, we can't get our brain around this. But God, if we pray, will give a way that that budget will be balanced. It'll be a miracle.
And this is powerful. And do you see, before we give the floor over to our co-host, Apostle Carlos Rosa here on Global Spiritual Revolution Radio, and I believe you gave a powerful prophecy back in 2015 concerning a coming second civil war. Do you, explain that to our audience, because that is so powerful. What is the Lord showing you concerning this second civil war?
Well, what the Lord showed me was if we stayed on the course that we were at that time, it was because of the abortion issues and the taking away of religious rights. It was, I mean, probably some of you listening from other nations cannot imagine how many of the civil rights of the churches in America have been taken away or were being taken away in the last administration. But the Lord showed me that if we continued on that course, that there would be some nations who would try to separate. Conversely, you know, now we see that the state of California, they're now even to talk of succession, you know, and if, which I don't believe they will, but like, for instance, Chuck Pierce prophesied maybe 10 years ago that by 2016, some states, California and Texas, would threaten to secede from the union. Well, when the conservative values, and I live in Texas, of the state of Texas were so being threatened, and we're a pro-life state, well, then there was talk rumbling in Texas. Well, we're not going to go along with this. And now the state of California, some are saying that we're signing petitions. We want to be out of the United States. Well, if they tried to pull out, there would be a civil war. And so we don't want it. It doesn't have to happen. But you just feel these rumblings going on.
Man, that is so much powerful apostolic insight. 929-477-3997. The board is lighting up. Amen. We got brand new revolution partners in additional to, it looks like, in addition, 25 countries to the 125 countries that are already listening tonight. This is the global impact of what Apostle Jacobs is bringing to the 21st century church. Our honorable co-host, the honorable Apostle Carlos Rosa of Relying on the Word Ministries International there in Anchorage, Alaska. Man of God, the floor is yours, Apostle.
Amen. Apostle Jacobs, other than praying, decreeing, and prophesying into the atmosphere for the change of our government, what do the people of this great nation of ours that we live in, not perfect, in any sense of the imagination, but yet still people trying to pour in to this nation because of the values and the freedoms that we have. What more can we do as a nation to back this president and this administration against this liberal mindset that has been captivated so much for the past 8 years, the changes that need to really be made for this nation to succeed forward in the greatness and move of God?
Well, I think number one, we need to be what I call prayer activists, pray and act. We need to show up at your city council meetings. We need to, if on your state level, they are coming against these values that are being put in place by this new administration, then tell them you're going to be out of office. They're politicians. Many of them will bow to that kind of pressure, and the churches should coalesce. The churches need to be voiced. The pastors, we never more needed the voice of the pastor to speak biblical truth from the pulpit than today.
Amen. Amen. Now, how do you feel, the Christian faith has been under attack and very much strongly now more than ever, especially when it comes to congressmen or senators of Muslim faith running for office, that the moment we speak against those things, we're being told that we're haters, we're not really showing the love of God, but yet this is a nation that was founded under the principles of God Almighty, or in God we trust, which is inscribed in our government buildings and even in our monies that are printed here in the United States, and what can we do as a people when we voice our voice, when these types of people try to not only get elected in office, but then at the same time try to instill their governing laws over to supersede the laws that we have here in the United States?
Well, we must speak up, because there is an ideology they bring. I have dear, dear friends, in other nations who didn't speak up, and now they have Sharia law in various portions of their nations that are not even under, the federal government's jurisdiction, these kind of things happening. And so, you're not speaking against someone because you're speaking for, for what is really right. Even as a nation as a whole, never in our history have we ever had like one group of people that didn't have to obey the laws of the nation. We have to obey the laws of the nation. What I'm saying. And so, there's quite a difference in truth, and our laws are based on biblical laws.
Well, that's powerful. 929-477-3997. We'll go back to Apostle in the next 2 minutes. We have with us world-renowned Apostle, prophet, evangelist, pastor, and teacher, a spiritual apostolic mother to, thousands of pastors and young ministers throughout the fivefold, throughout the world. 929-477-3997. And that is the Honorable Apostle Cindy Jacobs of Generals International there in the city of Red Oak, Texas. My next question, Apostle, what is the Lord showing you concerning, as we unlayer this government corruption? We see that what we call the deep state, the New World Order, this demonic structure called the Illuminati, their one point, their one goal is to destroy this man, President Donald J. Trump. What is the Lord showing you of the coming exposure of government corruption, including the hidden things of darkness and gross darkness as such as we never seen before. And, you know, we got pedophiles within our congressmen, within the Congress and Senate, that's coming out. You know, you got Barack Obama, you know, walking in the spirit of Antichrist, trying to operate a shadow government. What is the Lord showing you as we are going to see God expose this innate corruption?
Well, first of all, we are in our 50-state prayer network, the Reformation Prayer Network. We had massive prayer, whole prayer initiatives that corruption would be exposed. So it doesn't surprise us. It's being exposed. Some of you listeners may not understand deep state, but it's those that are embedded in different parts of the government that want to change the whole nation or overthrow Trump's administration. And there really are many that want to do that. And so that's what we're talking about here. And number one, do I believe there's a deep state? Yes, I do. I do. Mm. And do I believe that there are people that are more globalists? Yes. By globalists, I mean that a nation cannot have its own sovereignty. And so, yes, I do believe that's absolutely true. Were we headed that way? Absolutely, we were headed that way. I believe that God has raised up Trump because he's a strong man, and it's going to take a strong man to overthrow a strong man, of course, through the power of God. And, you know, so I think that's important. And, you know, the Bible says, woe to those who call evil good and good evil. What the liberal press is trying to do is make everything, every advance that has happened, evil. I mean, you know, for instance, some of the programs they say they're going to cut in the new budget for the poor. Well, of these massive programs that are out there, it'll be maybe 3% that might be cut or 3% from the government. You know, so there's a massive spin machine that's going on right now by people who are very skilled at information broadcasting. So we're going to have real discernment in this hour, what is real and what is not real. And I just want to say to the listeners, even not only for the U.S., but wherever you are, God is going to do that. And don't rely on the news you get on the international news as what is really real in America, because you can't trust it. I mean, people who live here know that. And, I mean, I know many, many prayer meetings have gone on with the president, around the president. There's many, many prayer meetings going on Capitol Hill. Just massive. I've just was on the phone today with five different networks planning prayer. There's 24-hour prayer for the president every day. People are getting on prayer chains. I mean, there's massive, massive prayer. So watch and see. It's Swamp Wars. It's going to get really ugly out there. But, you know, it just means that we're really affecting the kingdom of darkness. If you're going to go into your promised land to take it and there's no giants, you're only a tourist. You're not in the right land to occupy.
Apostle, the floor is yours, sir.
Amen. Apostle Jacobs, you talked about, you know, prayer, doing a prayer covering over the president, vice president, this administration, and our government officials. We have been hearing, my wife and I, when we discuss with people about praying for the nation, praying for the president and his administration, and we've been under attack, and I know others have been under attack, by saying, oh, now you want to pray. Where were you? Why weren't you praying for President Obama? You know, it's like they bring back a backlash, and then no matter how many times we tell them, the Word of God says to pray whoever is in authority. I said, we've been praying for President Obama, but he never took a course of action to change in the way that, you know, suited America in its Christian faith belief. It just went totally the opposite way. So then now, you know, is this recourse back oh, now y'all want to pray, you know, and then they want to bring race into it. And we tell them, so when we pray, it's not about race. It's about the establishment of the kingdom. What say you?
Well, Apostle, I'll tell you what God often tells me. Blessed are those when blessed are you when men persecute you and revile you and say all manner of evil against you falsely. I mean, the more visible you get, the more that's going to happen. I mean, just because I stand for Romans, the first chapter, I stand for biblical marriage. I'm not a hater. I actually had two different venues we were trying to rent turn me down today because I preach that marriage is between a man and a woman. So, you know, blessed. I just had to walk out and say, man, I'm blessed today. You know, it is hard, though. It's very difficult to be persecuted.
Apostle Jacobs, we know you're on the time schedule, and we can you come back to us? And I before you leave, I want you, with your permission, ma'am, to bless us with an apostolic blessing as an apostle. The word of the Lord says that we are receivers of the blessing of the apostolic, which is what we call the apostolicity, the apostles. And we are so fortunate here tonight on Global Spiritual Revolution Radio to have you. And we want you to come back, all right, because there's so much we want to get into, especially your book entitled Is That You, God? So can you go into a prophetical prayer, a blessing, blessing us not only as a international radio station of Global Spiritual Revolution Radio, but to bless our ministries, our families, and our homes in Jesus' mighty name.
Yes, thank you. That's an honor. Well, Father, I thank you, Lord, and I release your blessing. And just wherever you're listening, all around the world, we believe right now the Holy Spirit wants to touch you with a greater anointing, a greater influence, influence in your nations, voices in your nations. And the Lord would say over this radio and what you are doing, Bishop and Apostle, the Lord would say, I am in this. You're going into a John 17 mode, and you're going to network many people around the world. You're going to network the networks. Not only are they going to partner with you, but the Lord is going to show you how to lengthen your tent pegs, how to actually have a broader listenership, listening audience. Many people are going to come and listen, and the Lord would say that even though you're under persecution for your stance for righteousness right now, in the end, you will see it will pay off because I will give you a visibility in this, and I will give you a very influential voice that many will listen to and many will take heed until the Lord says there will be a time when the tables will be reversed. Even though you're suffering great persecution now, the trend will turn, the tables will turn, says the Lord, and I will give you great visibility. So your voices will have weight to change nations. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Apostle Jacobs. Can you come back and be with us again? Because we need your direction and we need your leadership.
Well, thank you. Yeah, well, we'll just really try to. We'll see what the Holy Spirit will allow us to do in the future. But God bless everyone listening around the world. And thank you all the way to Anchorage, Alaska there. Wow, that's a ways up.
Thank
there,
you.
Hold the fort.
God bless you, Apostle. God bless you in Jesus' mighty name. And to our Global Revolution partners, that was Apostle Cindy Jacobs of Generals International there in Dallas, Texas. And we're going to give the floor over to more questions as Apostle and I go forth in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We're going to take a two-minute break, amen, and as we prepare for our second guest, the Honorable Dr. Clarence Mason Weaver. He is the publisher, amen, of Mason Weaver Publishing Company there in St. Louis, Missouri. He is also, praise God, a world-renowned scholar when it comes to black conservatism. He was on with us a couple of weeks ago. and he will be with us in the next 26 minutes. Amen. So we're going to take a two-minute break here on Global Spiritual Revolution Radio. Amen. The boards here are lighting up with people who are listening online. Amen. And we are so excited. Amen. We're going to talk, Apostle and I, and to the rest of our Global Revolution partners, we're going to be discussing the post-teaching of remaking America in the image of God from this great woman of God, Pastor, Apostle, Amen, Cindy Jacobs. We see you in 2 minutes here on Global Spiritual Revolution Radio. Welcome back to Global Spiritual Revolution Radio here with your host and moderator, Bishop Larry Gators, along with our co-host, amen, the Honorable Apostle Carlos Rosa from Relying on the Word Ministries International there in Anchorage, Alaska. Apostle, what is the Lord speaking to you, sir, and through you concerning the apostolic impartation that Apostle Jacobs gave?
Well, it is what we've been talking about since throughout the program for quite some time, that we just got to stay to the grind. We got to stay before the face of God and releasing that which needs to be released in covering this president and its administration, and even now through the Supreme Court justice hearings. I mean, they've taken this man through a barrage of real nonsense, really. You know, when all they had to do, they had plenty of time to read his faith. But, I mean, they're dissecting him, you know, in a sense to ridicule his belief, his stance. And and this is just what the enemy just loves to do. You know, it's just, you know, it's there to, you know, the Word of God says, you know, that the devil is like, you know, he devours. You know, he's there to seek, steal, and destroy. That's all he's out to do. You know, once you're sought out, you know, he's out to destroy you, to dismantle you, you know, to discredit you, you know. Right. And, you know, as a voice of people of this nation, we got to really, you know, start being very active, you know. You know, just like an activist, you know, but not an activist in a bad sense, but an activist, you know, in the goodwill of God.
Oh, and you know what, Apostle, that is so much confirmation through you, man of God, you know, witnessing this barrage of questions to Judge Neil Gorsuch, and seeing the patheticness from the Democrats, from the senators, the Democratic senators, asking in questions that have nothing to do with the law, asking him political questions, you know, that have nothing to do with the law or the judicial system. And so I love what Judge Gorsuch said. I believe one of the Democratic senators asked him a question earlier today that did President Trump ask you to vote against Roe v. Wade or to remove it? And he said, well, number one, and I'm paraphrasing what the judge said. He said, number one, the president never asked me that. And number two, if he did, I would walk out of the room. This is a man, Judge Neil Gorsuch. He is a man of integrity. He is a man of great polity, great insights when it comes to the legality of U.S. law. And I believe that the Lord spoke to me today, man of God, that in the years to come, that God was going to elevate Judge Gorsuch to be the actual head of the Supreme Court in some years down the road, because he, it's sad. And with the Democrats drawing and dragging this out, and, you know, they are destroying themselves. And so asking him questions about his family and what he thought politically and what he thought about the FBI, I'm thinking, and I love what he said earlier. He said, you know, Justice Byron White was confirmed within 2 weeks, went to the Supreme Court, had a cigarette in his office, and was beginning to receive precedents, was beginning to receive court announcements and doing his job. And so, in other words, what he was saying, what the judge was saying, in essence, you know, listen, you've taken my family through this garbage, you know, and it's unfair. And he's going to get confirmed, it's no question. And a man of God, I read on the news today, within the national news today, that the FBI, the director of the FBI, James Comey, said that he was still investigating the Trump-Russia tie, the connection. And he kept saying up until this point, and I love what Trey Gowdy kept asking him, is there any connection to President Trump and to the Russians? He said no. And he kept asking him, he was saying, well, was there any voting manipulation in the states of Ohio, Michigan, Pennsylvania, Wisconsin? And the director said no. So here we are again, just like Judge Gorsuch. It just, you know, it's ridiculous, man of God. And they're trying to find something on the president, and they can't. What say you?
Well, yeah, what it really is looking like is they're grasping for straws.
And, right.
You know, no matter what answer they give, they're going to try to come up with another answer to either try to trip them up or get them, you know, to say something that they can say, oh, here is the aha moment. You know,
right.
We got them right here. Now let's drill this in. Now, you surely now can't confirm him because of what he just said. You know, but they ought to see. This is a man of integrity. It's been in his 70 dissertations before the court. You know, he's been very upstanding. Never strayed away from the law, never thought what he thought what the law should have been. You know, he's literal as what it is written and moves on from there.
And that's what it is. And I like he receives the questions that have everything to do with the legality of what he is applying for to be a Supreme Court justice. And he has rejected the nonsense the questions that have nothing to do with the law. And so it, we have a man that is going to stick to the law. And I like what he said also, Apostle, that no one is above the law, not even President Trump. And so that here is a man of great integrity, a man of great honesty. And another thing, another point I want to get with on the judge before we move to into the scriptures, into another point of today's political news, that Democratic senator or representative, Congressman Schiff, of the great state of Connecticut had said that the U.S. system may not be up to dealing with the Russia-Trump probe. In other words, what he's saying, there's no proof. And so now you not just have the Russia debacle, but you notice no one's even talking about the wiretapping, Apostle. No one's talking about that now, okay? And I noticed what Trey Gowdy said, okay, if there was no wiretapping, was there any surveillance, any spying within Trump Tower? And he could not, he couldn't deny or agree. And so that's telling us that there were wiretaps within Trump Tower. Go ahead, man of God.
Yeah, you know, and this is the thing that we keep talking about the grasping of straws. I mean, how much more are we going to beat this horse, you know, when it's already dead. It's already done. There's nothing else, you know, to continually completely convey on this. I mean, let's move on. But they're just not going to let it go. It goes to the same light of the previous administration.
Right.
No matter what, any time President Obama did something, even when it was wrong, well, you know, it was because of the previous administration.
Right.
He's trying to fix it because of the previous administration. You know,
right.
And they covered everything in the previous administration with the previous administration.
Right. And this is so, you know, we're instead of kicking the can down the road, we're kicking the can backwards. Well, like you said, Obama was saying it's Bush's fault, you know. But, you know, and the thing is, what President Trump is doing, he's done more in 50 to 60 days than President Obama has done in 4 years. This man, President Donald J. Trump, is proactive. He never gets any sleep, according to his wife and family. He's constantly working and he's, like we talked about before, man of God, many times here on Global Spiritual Revolution Radio, he has created a committee, an accountability committee that will hold him accountable as he check marks off all of his promises. And this is exactly what he is doing. And this immigration thing, I'm telling you, well, again, you got the courts, again, in Hawaii, and I believe it was Nevada or Oregon, blocking a second executive order as far as banning Muslims or banning those coming from six nations now. And so, man of God, we have to have God to intervene in this. And God forbid if something happens of another 9/11. What say you, Apostle?
Absolutely. You know, no one says anything is wrong until something happens, you know, but you can't go visit Israel and say, you know, hey, I'm tired of waiting in these long lines. You know, why don't we move on?
Right.
And, you know, I've been through here. You know, I mean, you're going through checkpoint after checkpoint after checkpoint. But then if you look at the history, you know, since the Munich situation, you haven't had another terrorist, you know, attack on an Israeli airline.
No.
You know? And, you know, and this is, you know, like you said, you know, you don't need a fire department while there's no fire, you know, but then the moment the fire is lit, now you're scrambling, where's the fire department?
Okay. See, and this is the problem. And you know, they're asking, again, these, oh, my God. I believe liberalism is a mental disease. And I believe it's in the DSM. which is the manual book for both psychologists and psychiatrists, that liberalism is a mental disease. But some of the Democratic senators was asking Judge Gorsuch today concerning quote-unquote dark money disclosures. I'm thinking, and the judge was looking at this Democratic senator. I said, this man is out of his mind. What does Judge Gorsuch have to do with dark money? Again, they're playing politics, man of God. And he will get confirmed. There's no question about it. But this is, man of God, the Democratic Party is destroying themselves. Am I right in saying that, sir?
Well, yes. And it's just a waste of time, is a waste of taxpayers' money. You know,
right.
Just let's move on from this. But it's the same adage, you know, you're talking to grown children, babies,
right.
You know, that don't
yeah.
want to let it go, you know. But then if Trump was to come back and say, hey, you lost already, give it up. Now,
right.
You know, everybody laughed when President Obama said that to Senator McCain in front of a lot of colleagues, you
right.
know. But then I guarantee you, if Trump was to say the same thing, oh, he's arrogant, he's this, he's that,
right.
you know. But, you know, he's playing to what he feels he needs to move America, and, you know, just let it go. I mean, enough is enough. It just gets to the point where, you know, it's going to eventually get to the point. They've already did a poll, you know, on American
right.
citizens, and I think it was at least 65% are just ready to move on. You know,
right.
the president, let's move on.
Let's move on. And it came out today, man of God, through the press secretary, Spice, and he was saying that that concern, there was a tragedy that happened. Spicer, he was saying that there was a tragedy that happened in a Montgomery County high school in Maryland, where a 14-year-old girl. And I want the Revolution Partners to hear this, because this is tragic. Sean Spicer was saying, the secretary, the press secretary for President Trump, was saying that a 14-year-old girl was raped by two classmates in a restroom. And these two classmates were not only illegal aliens or illegal immigrants, but these two young men were supposed to be in the ninth grade. This is ridiculous, Apostle. So you got two young men who were supposed to be in the ninth grade, okay, who are, what, 16, 17 years old. These things ought not to be, man of God. And this is what the people voted for. They want the borders closed. They want the wall. They want true immigration reform. You got a 14-year-old girl raped by two illegal aliens who were supposed to be in the ninth grade. Man of God, this is something that has to be fixed. Am I right in saying that, Apostle?
Well, you see, any tragedy of this kind is atrocious, you know, and both the left and the right need to speak up against this. You know, this goes beyond amnesty. You know, you wouldn't want your daughter to go through this if you had a daughter, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So why is it that the media is just looking over this, you know,
right.
because the moment they shed light to this, then it's going to add that fuel to that fire. Well, that's right. This is why we need to build the wall. This is why we need to protect the sovereignty of our nation. Now, I'm not saying that. And I know you're not saying that, and
no.
Global Revolutionary Partners, we are not saying that all Mexicans are bad, all Muslims are bad, you know.
Right.
But we have to do this as a whole to protect the sovereignty of our nation and vet the proper people in the way they need to be vetted. This is not about hating a particular race, hating
no.
a particular religion, or anything of that nature, but you got to do it in the right way. You come in, the way it's supposed to be done, and then, you know, you get your papers and, you know, and get processed in the way you need to get processed in, you know. But if you're here illegally and you commit a crime, you need to be gone as fast as you came in here. Because now for that young girl, like any other woman that is raped or any young child that is molested, now, you know, you got to pray for that individual. You know, there's a lot of psychological effects, emotional effects, physical effects, and spiritually deep down inside that now, you know, growing up, you're going to have to break through those barriers, because now for that individual to have a normal relationship, this is going to fester up. And that, you know, is gonna take a lot emotionally, physically, and spiritually.
And this is so true, Apostle. And I second that, sir, because this, you know, not, and again, what we're saying, Global Revolution Partners, we are not anti-Spanish. We're not anti-Mexican. We're not anti-Latino or Latina. But what we are anti-foolishness. And there has to be true immigration reform. And I believe that our president has his pulse on the emotional and the political, as well as the spiritual pulse of Americans. And this has to stop. I mean, the mayor of Los Angeles, Mayor Eric Garcetti, said that he was going to expand the immigration protections concerning immigrants. Again, this is a party, the Democratic Party, that has gone mad. And so it seems like they don't care. You got people. Ever since President Trump became elected back in the 8th of November 2016, you've had illegal. And again, what I'm saying, Revolution Partners, we are not anti-Mexican or Latino, as Apostle said. But ever since President Trump was nominated back on the 8th of November, you've had raping, killing, mugging, illegal immigrants driving with no license, you know, getting charged with drunk driving, killing people, murdering people. It's, you know, these are the demonic forces that are being exposed, as our guest had declared earlier, Apostle Jacob. So these are the things that we, as a global revolution ministry, we must espouse. Man of God, let's get into the scriptures here before Dr. Weaver comes on the line with us. One scripture, and just flow however the Lord leads you, Apostle, there in 1 Samuel 15:23, concerning the word rebellion. 1 Samuel 15:23. And I want to say this before the man of God reads that specific piece of scripture there in 1 Samuel 15:23. Amen. That Global Spiritual Revolution Radio here in New York City will begin broadcasting. And this is what Apostle had prophesied, that we will begin also broadcasting every Sunday morning at 10 a.m., on a greater syndicated national scale with Red State Rising Radio there in Dallas, Texas. Amen. And many, you got many of your famous conservative talk show hosts. Amen. Sean Hannity's there, Rush Limbaugh, Laura Ingraham. So Apostle and I have been favored by the Lord. Amen. Apostle Angela, Apostle Carlos, and I have been favored by the Lord to, now we're going not just on a national scale as far as with conservative talk radio, but also other parts of the world that we could not reach before. So we are beyond the 125 nations. Amen. Now we're up to 175 nations worldwide because of Red Nation Rising Radio. Also because of Talk Stream Live on Sunday nights from 7 to 9. We're just going to show and play all of the podcasts, the radio broadcast from this past week on Sunday morning and Sunday night. And I thank God. I thank God for Apostle Carlos and Apostle Angela. You guys are covering us spiritually and apostolically. And God is taking us to a new level. Amen. And we're going to be moving into a new radio studio as well. And we'll be talking to you more about that in the days to come. We're going to be moving to Long Island, praise God, and moving into a much bigger studio. So I give God all the praise and all the honor for he so richly deserves. Amen. We're waiting for Dr. Weaver to come on the line. Man of God, let's flow in the scriptures in 1 Samuel 15:23. And what is the Spirit of the Lord showing you tonight, man of God?
Amen. 1 Samuel 15:23 says, "For rebellion is as the sin of witchcraft, and stubbornness is as iniquity and idolatry. Because thou hast rejected the word of the Lord, he has also rejected thee from being king." Now, the key words here is rebellion. The other one is rejected and idolatry. Now, when we hit the word rebellion in the Hebrew, it means meri, okay, meri, which is being of a rebellious state of mind, rebellious consciousness, rebellious heart. Your lips are rebellious, you know. And then when you rebel against God, you're actually rebelling against His word. You're rebelling against the purpose of God.
But
you're rebelling against the will of God.
People say they're waiting for me.
You're rebelling
in the
against
audience.
The way of
other number. And then I'm online.
When you're rebelling against God in this way, you know, then you know how can the word move, you know, for a people? And then when we look at rejected, you know, and I mean when God says, "Because thou rejectest the word," that means you refused it and you despise it. When a person rejects
Apostle,
the word of God,
on for a second, Apostle. Please forgive me, Apostle. Dr. Weaver, you're on the line
That's
with us,
fine.
Sir.
Yes, I am.
All right, Dr. Weaver, please forgive us. Amen. In Jesus' mighty name, thank you for taking time out of your busy schedule. And forgive me, Apostle. We're going to pick back up on that near the end of the broadcast there in 1 Samuel 15:23. We have back with us, amen, the Honorable Mr. Clarence Mason Weaver. Dr. Weaver is a national and international voice for not only for black conservatism, amen. He is a mentor of men, a leader of men. And also, you know what, man of God, you are a man's man, Dr. Weaver. So thank you for taking out of your busy schedule to be back with us here tonight on Global Spiritual Revolution Radio. Thank you.
It's my pleasure. It's really a honor for God to place us all here at this point in time where we can witness such a tremendous miracle He is pouring out on the world right now. It's really a pleasure to sit and watch. Those who have eyes to see and ears to hear are really absorbing the blessing right now.
It is. It is. And what is the Lord showing you, man of God? The state, and we're going to pick back up where we left off last time, but I want us to go into the topic, remaking America in the image of God. What is the first step that we as men have to do, have to take? What is the first step we have to take as men to remake America in God's image?
As men, wow, what a provoking thought. There is a job for men. It's amazing because America is saying that we're all equal. America is saying there's no difference between men and women, that men are just as weak as women, and women are just as strong as men. But what's going to take is for us to go back to that garden, to go back where God placed us to protect and to keep men, to protect and to keep the garden. Our job was to protect it. Now, God will not give you a task without first have given you the power to do the task. So if God told man to keep and protect, that word means to put a hedge around it,
right,
protect a wall around it. Now, if he told man to do that, he would have already given man the power to do that. And that's why Satan went to Eve instead of man, because he knew that man had the power to put him out of the garden. He had the power to resist him because he was going after what God had given him, and God told him to protect everything that he had in that garden, including Eve. So the first thing man must do is recognize his authority and position with God. He must first recognize he has the power to cast out and to bind up and to protect. We have lost our protective spirit now. Men nowadays are just breeders. We hunt women. We breed and move on. There's a difference between a girlfriend and a wife. There's a difference between a boyfriend and a husband. God does not give grown men girlfriends. And this is the last time I was on the air. So the first thing has to happen that men must recognize we are to protect the spirit of our families. And we have to first stand up. If you stand up for God, you're standing up against the evil. And the evil will immediately recognize you as a target. The evil will immediately come after you. All it has is a voice. All evil has is a voice. That's why they call you a name. That's why they tell you you're mean. That's why they call you a sinner. That's why they threaten you. They only have a voice. You, man, have the spirit of God. That voice will melt before you if you act like you believe God and walk towards that enemy like Goliath or the Jordan River or the Red Sea or the walls of Jericho. You walk toward it, it will fall to your feet. But you must first, man.
It doesn't seem like to you, man of God, and we're going to get the floor over to our co-host, to Apostle Carlos Rosa. Man of God, and we have with us a man, a great, great leader, and not only a national leader, a global leader. This man of God, Dr. Clarence Mason Weaver, is a man's man. And what I mean by that, he is a leader of men, a man that is the man of his home, the man of his family. And this is what we are going to examine tonight as we remake America in the image of God. Quickly, Dr. Weaver, why are there so many women, what we call true Eves, keep falling in love with counterfeit Adams? And what I mean by counterfeit Adam, he is only a male from the waist down, but he's not a man for the neck up. Why is these so many women who become bitter later on attracted to men who are bad boys, attracted to men who keep constantly abusing them? Why is this, man?
You know, you're going to make me laugh if you don't get me in trouble now. But look.
Come on now.
here's the problem.
Yes, sir.
Women are nurturers. They think they have the creative power. They want to create good out of bad. They make an ugly house pretty. They make a room to bring in flowers. They see anything, they want to make it better. I don't care what it is. You got a car, they want to put a pinstripe down it. It doesn't matter what is before them. They are creative.
Right.
They are the creative. They make a baby. They make a baby into a wrong person. So they see a bad person, they say, I can change him. I can work with him. I can correct that. And they're more attractive because that bad guy needs them. A strong man doesn't need them. They don't feel like they have anything to offer a strong man. And they think with their love, but gee whiz, look, everybody wants them. Every man is attracted to them. Every man wants to seduce them. That means they must be powerful. They must be influential. And if I give this man what he is looking for and seeking for, surely he will convert and change for me because my love is so strong. And if it doesn't work, I must give him more then. I must give him more because if I know I'm so attractive, I'm so beautiful, that he will give his life for me. And, of course, the more she gives him what he wants, the less he gives her what she wants because she will continue to give him more. So to answer your question, the reason women want these little boys is that they're trying to raise them into men. And if a strong man comes along, you brothers, you see these women, and you know you're a righteous man. you must first go and possess her. You must first seduce her. You must first tell her it's okay. You can say anything you want to a woman if you say it while you're embracing her. And, and if you do that, if you embrace her in your arms, you feel your strength around her, she will relax that foolish impulse she has to be a man. Don't forget, she told, I mean, Satan told Eve, you'll be like God. And Eve said, that's a good idea. I can be like God. Think about it. He showed her a ragtag sale at Macy's, brother. He showed her how good it's going to look, how wonderful it's going to make her feel. And she, the Bible says, when she saw it would make her good, it would be good for her. When she saw it was beautiful, it was on sale. If I don't get it, the other ladies would get it. And she took it because it would make her good. And then she turned and gave it to her man. The only creature who could have given Adam something like that was the perfect creature God made for him. And the reason women today are still rebelling, they're still trying to be what Eve tried to be. They're trying to be the God and director of their men. And I want to say one more thing. Before, every woman listening today has said to themselves and to their girlfriends and to anybody listen, they are a Proverbs 31 woman. They all say, I'm going to be a Proverbs 31 woman. Well, let me tell you something about that Proverbs 31 woman. Everything she did to honor her husband.
Yes.
She was first a wife. So in order to be a Proverbs 31 woman, you must be a submissive, agreeable wife.
And you know what, Dr. Weaver, before we give the floor over to our co-host, Apostle Colas Rosa, one more quick question. When we examine the scriptures, and I'm so glad and happy that you're bringing up Adam and Eve, and that the scriptures clearly state that God gave Adam the garden. Eve didn't have a garden. Eve didn't have a house. Eve didn't have, quote unquote, a crib. So every man who goes into marriage has to have his own. And because you got so many men who want to be taken care of. And so Adam was given the responsibility of the garden to dress and to keep it. Yeah. Man, oh God.
Now, if you look at that situation, Eve had nothing, but she had God's word, and Satan had emotion, and Satan won because woman is emotional. So, fellas, men, listen. If you are not the man of your house, Satan is.
Oh, Lord, have mercy.
Because see, God, no matter what Eve did, Adam had done nothing. And God went to Eve and said, her punishment is personal. You're going to have labor problems. You're going to have childbirth problems, pain, and you will desire.
Right.
You will desire. Just say you may desire. You will desire a husband. And that was personal. The snake's going to be in between you and God. It's personal to Adam. He turned to Adam, who had done nothing except didn't defend his kingdom. And God said to Adam, curse is the ground for your sake. The whole earth was cursed for Adam's sake, not Eve's sake, because Adam failed to obey God and protect his kingdom. It was all Adam's fault, not Eve's fault, because Eve just tried to do her best to remake the world in her image. Bless her heart. Had she done that and Adam still stayed pure, we'd have had peace on earth. Instead, Adam tried to sue his wife and disobey God, and because God made her the most adorable creature on the planet. Don't forget, now, God took his time. The creator of the universe took his time to form Eve. And that's why her form drives us out of our mind, because he took it for our own good. It ain't good for man to be alone. When he formed something that was so good for us, we'll give our kingdom up for it. And that's the plight of man right now.
Oh, my God, 929-477-3997. Again, beloved, that's 929-477-3997. Our lights, our board here is lighting up. We're getting more men, looks like, who are listening online, as well as we speak. We have with us the Honorable Dr. Clarence Mason Weaver. He is a world-renowned author, speaker, lecturer, publisher, and he is a man's man. and any man, black, white, brown, purple, or red, I don't care what your color is, this man of God, you have to reach out to in order for God to speak through him to impart into you. Amen. Apostle Rosa, the floor is yours, sir.
Amen. Brother Clarence, I'm glad you're mentioning this about the God cursing the ground that man walked in, because years and years ago, and my wife and I are going into 34 years of marriage. Years and years ago, the devil seduced me, and I strayed away from God. Thank God, you know, years later, I got back right. And when I strayed away, I was looking at divorcing my wife and this and that. Well, the Lord pulled me off to the side, and he had a clear conversation with me after 3 years in hiatus. And the Lord said, if you want a divorce, I'll grant you a divorce. I said, but remember this. It was me, your God, that brought you two together where you lived in the East Coast, she was in the West Coast, and y'all met in the central of the United States in Texas. He says, it was me. He says, but I'll tell you this. If you want a divorce, I'll grant it. But nothing you lay your hands on will prosper.
Mm.
You know, and he was telling me that as the man, you know. So, you know, I asked God for forgiveness. He forgave me. Then I, in turn, went to my family, asked them for forgiveness, my wife for forgiveness, and the Lord elevated our lives, our marriage, everything to another level, okay,
wow.
In him. So
amen.
Why is it you have awesome women of God in the church? They're single, they're strong-minded, you know, they're anointed, but yet, within that anointing, they allow themselves to get seduced by trickster suitors that come into the church, know how to act safe, sound safe, but these women under the anointing can see that they're not. Why do they still fall for this when there are other great men surrounded that they can get to
and have great. Great men are boring to these women. You kidding me? They're no challenge. They can't fix nothing, and they will not take their direction. These women want to be worshipped. They're beautiful. They're godly. They're godly. They're full of the Holy Spirit, and they wear them pretty hats, and they want to be worshipped for their beauty. And these bad boys will worship them as long as they get them car keys. They'll tell you whatever the heck you want to hear. I'm raising a little girlfriend. I'm raising granddaughter right now, man. I'm telling them, you will be lied to. You are made to be seduced. What protects you from being produced? What protects you from being seduced? What protects you from being lied to? What protects you to be taken advantage of is me, my brothers, my male cousins, the men around you. And we're not going to tell you he's a bad boy. We're going to tell him he's a bad boy. And he ain't going to feel comfortable. What it's going to take is the deacons in that church waking up. Hey, Junior, let's talk for a minute, bro. Let's talk, bro. Let's go for a ride in the woods. This ain't going to work here. It's like, we recognize that mess. But we so busy trying to fill the church seats. The church today is full of women. Men aren't in the church anymore. Some homosexual men in the choir. And you got men sitting at home watching the game and tell that girl, go to church and bring me a sandwich back and some money. And we sit back and wonder what's wrong with our women. What's wrong is the men have not stood up and said, there be no man in my company. There be no man in my presence. That's not right. There be no man. You're not going to be comfortable around me. I had a dude come to me, a nice young man, had enough nerves to come to me and tell me he liked my 14-year-old granddaughter. Nice young man. Took a lot of nerves. You know that? Especially if you know me. It took a lot of nerves with a brother. So he came in, I liked it, granddaughter. I like to get to know her better. And I said, young man, let me ask you a question. you like her, but I love her. Do you like her enough to die for her? Because I love her enough to kill for her. He said no. I mean, grow up and come back. And his father said, well, 14 is a little young to be trying to die for a girl. I said, that's my point. With old enough, come knock on my door. Maybe 18, maybe 20. But she's around my man right now. Her male cousins will die for her. I told the father, I would die for your wife. If I see her in a burning building or a car turned over, I'll stop and get my life trying to protect her and raise her and rescue her. So why would I want to bore about my young girl that doesn't see her as valuable as I see your wife?
This is powerful. This is powerful. And man of God, do you agree, too? And we're going to go back to Apostle in the next few minutes here. We have with us Dr. Clarence Mason Weaver. Amen. He is a nationally and internationally recognized scholar of black conservatism, coming off of the plantation. He is a mentor of men. He is a leader, a national leader, amen, that is Christ-centered. And we are so privileged and honored that he has taken time out of his busy schedule to be back with us here on Global Spiritual Revolution Radio. A man of God, when we examine the scriptures and we're talking about remaking America in the image of God, actually specifically beginning with the man, in Genesis, chapter number 2 and 3, we see, and specifically chapter 3, we see that the serpent, he does not go to Adam in Genesis chapter 3.
Nope.
The serpent goes to the woman, and incidentally, she is not named Eve until after the fall. But my question is, man of God, do you think there was some crack in the foundation of the relationship between Adam and Eve that would allow the woman to be invaded by a foreign entity such as this serpent? Because many times there's infidelity in the marriage. Many times because there's problems in the foundation. I always believe if a man loves a woman, he'll never cheat on his wife. If a woman loves a man, she'll never cheat on her husband. Do you think that there were some insecurities in Eve, or some there was problems in the marriage relationship between Adam and the woman in order for the serpent to gain that type of access?
Well, you know, brother, I think the problem was that Eve was just so fine. I mean, I mean, Satan was there. He was there. The Bible said that Eve gave to her husband who was with her. He was there with her. Satan was there with Adam. Adam just didn't want to tell his wife no because she was so beautiful. She was so fine. Don't forget now, God thought about Eve and Adam. When God presented Eve to Adam, he gave her name. He said, wow, whoa, man, and gave her name. It was the fact that she was easily manipulated. We all know, every man listening knows, women are easily manipulated because they're full of emotions, and Satan looked at the emotions. Look at it, it'll make you wise. God just don't want you to be like him. He's going to make you pretty and wise, huh? And he took that. Adam should have said, fool, get behind me. Get out of my kingdom. When my wife and I first got together 30-some years ago, she had a very strong father, and she was a very intelligent, very hard-driven woman, and I was a man, and we had a little conflict in me, a little conflict on who is going to be the man of this house. And I took up, like I told you, I took up my arms. You can say anything to your wife and you say it while you're embracing her. She will stop talking. And I told her, you know, I will conquer the world for you and live at your feet. But I will not come home and be conquered by you. If I'm not man enough for you to live for, how can you be woman enough for me to die for? Who's going to be the man? Who's going to be the female? Let's decide right now. And from that day forward, you said to me, you be the man. She has fought me since. She has not fought me since.
That's powerful. 929-477-3997. Again, 929-477-3997. You live outside of the continental United States, and a lot of there are a lot of men who are listening online, also throughout the Caribbean islands and Kingston, Jamaica, Grenada, Nassau, Bahamas, and St. Thomas, the Virgin Islands. Thank you for joining the Global International Family of Global Spiritual Revolution Radio. Amen. We have with us Dr. Clarence Nathan Weaver, a nationally and internationally known, amen, speaker, lecturer, amen, also a mentor of men. And we are discussing remaking America in the image of God. Apostle, the floor is yours, sir.
Amen. So can we say, Dr. Weaver, that the reason why President Trump is hated is because he's a strong man? You know, because we've seen in Congress and in Senate a lot of these men that cow down when Maxine Waters raises her voice, you know, or all these other women. I'm not saying that, you know, they shouldn't have a voice, you know, but I'm saying that, you know, sometimes people can act loud, you know, to make a scene because there's really nothing behind it. You know, when other women can speak, you know, and they're heard properly.
Yes, sir. So, you know, Reverend, it's strange that a loud woman is considered a strong woman, but a loud man is considered dangerous. Now, Maxine Murphy Waters is nothing but a God-hating, man-hating, American-hating woman who is a socialist. She has watched her people become dependent and enslaved. She's watched her women murdered. She's watched the young children become drug addicts and drug dealers. She has watched in L.A. her people become nothing but slaves, and she has been elevated by the slave master. I have no respect for her. I have no use for her. I was on a radio program interviewing another Democratic socialist, John Conyers, and I was pretty rough on him. I took a break, and she came on the radio in his place. And I blasted her. I said, I'm embarrassed to be on the radio with you. How dare you be in my presence? Don't you know who you are? Where's your husband? I don't argue with women. Get off the phone. I have no respect for her. And all of the other black, I call them black communist leaders in the Congress. What we need in America are men to stand up first before God and apologize to God. We are sorry for allowing our nation to be like this. We are godly men. We know who God is. And we are allowing the ungodly to stay in our presence and be comfortable in our presence. And we are silent in the midst of their lies. All it will take is just a few of us to stand up. This election cycle, I have never seen so many men on their face. I don't mean their knees. I mean prostrated out on the ground, on their face before God, across this country. And we were not just asking for deliverance from the darkness we saw come with Hillary. We're asking God to forgive us for allowing this, for allowing the Democrats and liberals to take control of our schools and educate our kids to hate God and hate us. We're sorry for allowing them to take our money and perpetrate this fraud on us with welfare and Planned Parenthood. We are sorry for allowing our entertainment industry to turn our children into zombies. Men are so afraid of losing the sexual affairs of women that we are still willing, like Adam, to give up our kingdom to serve her instead of serving God.
Man, that's powerful. Oh, my God. And you know what, man of God? A thought came to my mind, Dr. Weaver, and I'm going to walk through this slow to a lot of our the sisters who are a part of this global international revolution here at Global Spiritual Revolution Radio. And I want you sisters to listen carefully there, and I want Dr. Weaver to correspond and to break this down what I'm about to say. There is not in every woman, but I've witnessed, I've counseled to a lot of couples in the past, Dr. Weaver. A lot of men, married men, have been so frustrated down through the years. Not all women, but some in the church are using, excuse the expression, the power of sex as a weapon against their husband, that if he doesn't do this, that, and the other for her, then she were closed up old in the Testament. And
Lord
so
have mercy.
This is demonic. Paul said to the Christian.
I know, you're right. You're right.
Yeah, that the husband and wife, they are unified physically, mentally, spiritually, and so women and also men are using this sexual thing as a power tool, as a power play. Why is that, Dr. Weaver?
Because we've lost touch with who we are as men. Let's be honest, fellas. Come on, you understand. If your wife can cut you off and she not suffer more because of it than you do, you're not getting a job anyway.
No.
How can your woman say no to you? You're such a loving creature. She has no power over that. You have to be such a man that she will melt in your arms. All that foolishness will go. The problem is you're allowing her to be the co-king. She can't be the co-king. You got to be the king, and if she wants to be a queen, you cannot have a queen without having a king. So, and in church, the real problem is in church, because churches are now full of women seeking some identity, and these men out here, man, if you let your woman control you sexually, you are a boy. I don't mean this to be rough and tough. You have to be such a honorable man that your woman will not. I've been married 30 years. If I go out of town for a week, my woman's climbing the wall because brother gone. You cannot allow that sexuality to be a tool. It must be a reward, brothers.
And before we give the floor over to our co-host, the Honorable Apostle Carlos Rosa, we have with us Dr. Clarence Mason Weaver, a nationally known speaker, lecturer, nationally known spiritual father, not just to black men, but to all men, and teaching us how to be responsible men here in the 21st century. All right, Dr. Weaver, another question here. And we see, again, getting back to the scriptures in the third chapter of Genesis. So the scene is here that the serpent comes, and his sole intent is to emasculate Adam in order to emasculate Eve. We see Hollywood emasculating not just black men, but emasculating men.
Yep,
in
manhood.
Order to emasculate women. Man of God, this is demonic. Am I right in saying that, sir?
It is the original demonic intent on humans. It is the original intent, because that man, don't forget, he has authority from God to handle Satan. He has to keep it and protect it. And so there's an interesting study. One day you may want to do a program on this. Why was Satan in the garden? Why was he even on earth? Why is he so angry with us? Why are we the target of hate? What are we going to do to him? And once you understand, this is why Eve had a choice. Once Eve decided to disobey God and partake of that fruit, she had two choices. She could have taken the fruit of eternal life or the fruit of knowledge of good and evil. Why did she take the fruit of good and evil and not the one for eternal life? She will live forever. Because mankind believes today that they can gain enough knowledge to live forever. They believe that knowledge is the key. It's called science. And they will follow science, thinking that one day they're going to discover how to keep cells from stop regenerating, and they will live forever based on their own knowledge, not God. And they're still doing that today. They're full of brain. If you want America to come back to God, it's going to take churches to start getting rid of these clouds in church. You got to start turning over the money tables in church. You got to start getting these unsaved pastors out of the pulpit. You got to stand before the people of God and say that what God wants us to do, and then you have to lead folks to the Jordan, go their behalf in the Jordan, and cross over to the promised land, which is righteousness. If we don't do that, we're going to continue to see them standing before us like Goliath. Lying and blaspheming God every day before the people of God. And we're standing on the hillside like the Israeli army, afraid of Goliath. because he's talking loud, he's talking bird, and tell us how dangerous he is, how tough he is, and a child will come out one day and cut his head off because he is a heathen and he is dead because God said he's dead already. If you want the country back, it takes a miracle. And the only way you're going to get a miracle in this country is by God keeping his word. And the only way God will keep his word is if we act like we believe God.
My God. 929-477-3997. Remaking America in the Image of God here on Global Spiritual Revolution Radio. Back with us, amen, the Honorable Dr. Clarence Mason Weaver. Amen. Apostle, the floor is yours, sir.
Amen. You know, you're absolutely right, Dr. Weaver, about demasculating the man. That, been going on and on, but now, from the previous administration, it has made it, you know, carte blanche. I mean, you have every time you go to see the Oscars or the Academy Awards or any of the music awards, they're constantly throwing that out into the face of America. We are here. We're here to stay. This is who we are, you know, and it's like with no recourse or anything like that. And what we really need is for the judgment of God to move against this type of rebellion and sin. What say you?
Well, you know, you're right. Every commercial, every television, entertainment, international between a man and woman, everything shows the man to be weak and stupid and dumb and with no power and no influence. Every commercial, every comedic act, everything. The man is stupid, the female is strong. Even the children are stronger than the man. And so we encourage to be weak. And don't forget, men will do anything for sex. We will be weak for sex. You guys still get in the car? I have to protect you anymore. I ain't got to check your house anymore. I have to defend you no more, but I still get to go. Okay, come on, I'll be that. And men will give that up. I had a program, I was on TV, I think it was Fox, with a young lady, and she was all powerful, strong, and I made a comment, I am not a metrosexual man. And she was stunned, I would say that. Are you kidding me? What kind of man are you, she said. I'm a grown one. What do you think? I'm not going to apologize for my manhood? Are you kidding me? I'm not going to apologize for being masculine. I'm not going to apologize for being strong and aggressive. I'm not going to apologize. Are you joking? And so we think women now have got, see, somebody is going to be the husband of that woman. Somebody or something will be the dominant person in that woman's life. Right now, it's the government. They have babies, and the government takes care of the babies for them. They need a house. The government gives them housing. The government should have a job. The government is the new husband, and the men are just sitting there. We just sperm donors. We're making babies. We're not raising children. So if you have a man outside the home sending a check and not in the home checking up, you have a weak home. I don't care how strong that woman is. Your home is weaker because you got buried down the street somewhere. And also more vulnerable. If you want to rebuild America, we must first rebuild the man and bring back manhood and bring back aggressiveness and bring back solid leadership. We must stop following Eve. We must stop following the emotions. We must stop following this game of who did what to who. Stop following victimhood. We have to stand up for God. If we do that, the holy angels of God will help us in this spiritual battle, and we will force the darkness away. Darkness does not come, folks. Darkness leaves when the lights come. When the sun comes up, darkness must leave. You don't have a light for dark. You don't have a flashlight and a dark light. You got flash. You got light. So let your light shine, and darkness must, it must depart from before you.
My God, that is so powerful. 929-477-3997. And we will go back to our co-host, the Honorable Apostle. Call us real soon here in the next few minutes. We have with us Dr. Clarence Weaver, amen, nationally and internationally known, amen, lecturer, author, amen, also a man's man, a mentor, a publisher. This is a man who was a former Black Panther, but is now liberated within the power of the Lord Jesus Christ as a conservative. Amen. 929-477-3997. Man of God, again, let me see what you think of this man of God. And correct me if I'm wrong, Dr. Weaver, and also Apostle Carlos as well. Man was created in the image of God, the woman was created in the image of man, who was created in the image of God. What say you, Dr. Weaver? And we're going to go to Apostle Callers with that. Again, man was created in the image of God. His woman is created in the image of her man, who is created in the image of God.
And God created both, but that woman was a special creation by God. That woman was given to us to bear our children. That's why we call her woman. It's a special job, and that's why she is short. That's where the kids are. That's why she's not tall. We're told to see down the path. She's tall to see the danger at her foot. That's why she's not strong. If you have a man and a woman on an island somewhere, and that woman just had a baby, if one of them had to die, which one's death will cause the baby's death also? The woman's death. So we're made to die. We're a sacrificial lamb, like Christ was for us. We should hold our wives flawless and blameless, like Christ held us. And we're to sacrifice ourselves, and they raise the children up in our name, in our honor, because we give our life for them. Instead, in the black communities in California, in the United States, they're raising the children in the name of their mother. They give their mother's names to them. That's dishonoring the manhood. We will not be back as a nation until men start standing up and being men. I talked to my grandchildren. Last thing I did, I had this discussion with them today. I talked about inheritance. I said, you're gonna inherit my books and my lectures and my tape series. And so, if I die, you and your children will be getting money for what Grandpa did. I'm leaving with an inheritance, and I'm training you to take care of inheritance, and I will assure you have a man in your life who will also honor the gift I'm giving you, not to squander it. So that's why I'm so much in alignment. This is generational. If men start thinking about the next generation instead of the next party at the club, if men start thinking about Nike stock instead of Nike shoes, if we start thinking about what we're going to leave our great-grandkids, we'd be a better nation.
Oh, Apostle Carlos.
Yeah, you're absolutely right on that statement, you know, that man is created in the image of God, and woman came from man. That's why we twain as one. Like my wife and I, you know, now going on 34 years, you know, we almost think alike.
Amen.
Reactionary alike. I mean, I can look at my phone and say, you know what, let me call baby, and the phone will ring, and I'll be, and vice versa, because we twain as one in the holiness and purity of God, that you start thinking as one, just the way God designed it to be. You know,
how
mannerisms are alike. You know, and that's the part of the growing, because when God created woman from man, that is so close. That is so dear to the man. That's why, you know, I just don't understand how you have these ignorant, hard-headed men that just don't know how to treasure the jewel and the gem that they have.
You know, brother, my wife and I can be driving in the car. I've been married 31 years. We can be driving in the car, and we'll both look at the same thing out the window and comment about the car or the cloud or the tree or the store or another car. We'll be looking at the same things. It is just amazing how much she and I are just like we're just twins. Think alike, speak alike, want the same things. We found this house here. I've been looking 2 years, 7 trips to Missouri, looked at 200 homes. When we saw this house, we both knew it was home. We made the offer in 10 minutes. And this is my 7th home. We did it on most of our homes. When we saw it, we knew exactly that was home because it was one.
Man, that's powerful, man. And you know what, man of God, another thought came to my mind. We're going to go back to Apostle in a few minutes here. And we have with us back on Global Spiritual Revolution Radio, amen, world-renowned author, speaker, amen, lecturer, world-renowned spiritual father to black men, to men, teaching us, amen, how to be men from the neck up. That is very important. 929-477-3997. Again, getting back to the scriptures about Adam and Eve, I had a rabbinical messianic rabbi friend of mine told me years ago, Dr. Weaver, an apostle, that the rabbinical, the origin or the origination of the word Adam is not a name, but is actually a way of thinking, and that the term Adam actually means atom, capital A-T-O-M, the Adam. And so Adam,
wow,
when God breathed into him, the Adam became the atom. He became a particle from God. He became a cell of God. And that the woman who came from his rib rabbinically represents proton, okay? The proton in becoming the helpmate to the atom. And so you got atoms wanting to become protons, and protons wanting to become Adam. And you got atoms who are marrying fractured ribs. Men who have married fractured, broken ribs, okay, which are causing them pain. And you have true women, true Eves, who have married not a man, but a child of Adam. Right. A man that is broken. Why is this, Dr. Weaver?
Wow. That's pretty deep,
that's
brother.
Powerful.
You know, when you have a situation where men and women aren't mature enough to recognize they're men and women, you have the last continent. You know, we have in America today, we have men trying to be women and women trying to be men,
right,
and they argue about the differences. It is amazing to me to watch the character of the darkness. You know, we're told each time we gain power in this country, we're told to reach out to the other side. God said, come out from among them. We try to make friends, and God says, go tell them the gospel. He didn't say go convince them of the gospel. He said go tell them and move on down the road and let somebody else come and water seeds or fertilize the seed. But you stay there and argue with these fools. It's like cursing the darkness. So we have me. I tell ladies, you know, I've talked to women groups, not much as I used to, but I tell women, you know, you have only a couple of things to blame. If the men in your pool of men are not worthy to be men, there's two bad things about men. First, most men were raised by women, and you chose our daddies.
Mm.
So if you got a problem with how men are, ain't no men around, you are raising them, and you chose who daddy was. Was daddy around?
That's powerful. Apostle.
The Bible says that if a man finds a woman, he finds a good thing. It doesn't say that a woman finds a good man. You don't find a good man. We're the harshest, not you. You're the flower, not the bee. The flower does not pull itself out the ground and chase a doggone bee down. That's your job.
And you just said a scripture, and we're going to get to Apostle in about 10 seconds. He that findeth the way findeth a good thing. But we got this thing backwards today, Dr. Weaver. We don't have men going after women. We got women going after men. We got women, not all women, who so intent when they go to church, not all, but some, is to find a man. And they got this, men and women got this fixation within their minds that if a man says, if I can get a woman, I'll be complete. The woman says, if I can get a man, I'll be complete. But they got this thing backwards. Dr. in yep. Apostle Carlos, is that you don't get married in order to be completed, but the man and the woman must already been completed by Christ before they get married. And Apostle, the floor is yours, sir.
Just backtracking right quick on that completeness. When you're talking about the atom and the proton, a couple of years ago, I ministered a message about the proton believer. And in that message, I talked about our ministry can only succeed as much as I honor my proton believer, which is my wife, you know, because she is not only my inspiration, she is also my covering. She is also the anointing I lean on other than God, you know, and in ministering that, you know, I was looking and got a lot of pushback, but I was letting them know, because we as men can be self-centered, we can be very prideful, very arrogant,
but if
we don't ever recognize the anointing beside us, and I remember God let me know, he says, you'll only go as far as you trust the anointing on your wife. I said, do you trust that? As you trust me, you know, and, you know, I was a little bewildered by that, but he says, it's real simple. He says, you know, I joined you together. So if you twain as one in me, then she not only trusts your anointing, but you also have to trust her anointing as well. Because when no one's covering you, she is. And that is the creation of that Adam, which brings about the creation of the molecular structure that brings that proton and that neutron together, and they spin and evolve within each other.
Well, you know, you're right, brother. If men are hunters, we are hunters by nature. If we're hunters, if we spend all our time hunting for another woman, to conquer one, to get another one, that takes up so much of your day, so much of your time, so much of your resources. You got to hunt. If you're a single man, you spend your time trying to find a sports car and a new boy to go to. You're trying to conquer a woman with all, let's say, all your money, all your time. You cannot build a business. You can name very many successful men that are not married. Look at gang members. Gang members are single men. Police are married men. You have to have a reason to use your strength, and that woman tames you. She matures you. You now have a reason to conquer the world. Because if you don't have that reason, brother, you're searching again the next night for a new conquest, and you cannot build up a kingdom. You cannot build an inheritance. You must have a reason to give your life for something. And that single man, every society that has a band of single men running through them is a failing society. In Africa, we have more than one woman. It's a failed society. In America, we now have single men roaming over our women, and our society is coming apart. So men must make a decision. Women, you must make a decision on who you are before God. Do you want a man to pray over you or a man to pray on you? Your decision.
And you know what, too, men of God, as we talk about remaking America in the image of God, beginning with the man, is that men today and women today are being deceived by Lucifer, who is Satan, the devil today. And I've always said this to the Global Revolution partners, that when you dissect the first letters of the names Lucifer, L, Satan, S, devil, D, you get the word LSD. So this devil, Satan, has deceived a lot of people in the church by believing, if I can just go on to eharmony.demon, if I can just go on to math.hell, if I can just go on to Christian Mingle going straight to the abyss, I'll find a woman. So what they're saying to God is, gentlemen, is that I don't trust you, Lord, to send me a woman as a man, or to send me a woman as a man, or to send me a man as a woman. What they're saying, we don't trust the Lord. So we're going to help you, Lord. We're going to help the Lord. And I'm going to use my credit card. This is a man saying. I'm going to use my credit card to purchase me my own rib. The woman is saying, I'm going to use my credit card to purchase me my own Adam, okay, or my own Boaz. I heard a preacher say once, and I'm not cussing when I'm about to say it. All these women want a Boaz. You got one? Now he's beating your ass. I'm not cussing. He is kicking your. He's lying to. So all these women want a Boaz. But they don't
sure do.
Yeah, they, but they don't want God.
Women don't want men that carry their luggage for them. They want men to carry their luggage and kill their bugs. We just handy tools for them now. They don't want to love them. They don't want to provide them. They don't want to be secure. They don't want to be nothing.
Yeah.
They want to be taken advantage of and lied to. They reward the best liar. Even if they know it's a lie. If it's
right.
If it's really good, they reward him with themselves because he must love me so much to lie to me that way. Deception.
And
they know God's lying. So to answer your question, how do we rebuild America? Brothers, we have to start with the church and the men in it. We got to start cleaning up prayer, and we have to present ourselves to women as the only choice for security for your children, safety for your own, and life everlasting. We are the key to God, and we must act like it and stand before the people, and God will redeem our country back to us for the goodness of Adam, like he took the earth from us for the same reason.
Dr. Weaver, what's the difference between love and being in love? What's the difference? Yeah, go ahead, sir.
To me, being in love, when I met my wife a block away in the bus stop, it was wintertime, big overcoat on, no makeup on, hot water pants on. I fell deep in love a block away. It was a chemical reaction in my body. My spirit jumped. I almost broke my leg right down that hill to meet her. I couldn't see nothing. But it wasn't her beauty. It was something spiritual. I had to run down that hill, huffing and puffing, and it took me 2 weeks to get her name. In love with her is 30 years of building things together, 30 years of going through things together, her breast cancer, her heart failure, love her through her death of her mother, her two sisters, building up these children, these grandchildren. That is why I'm in love with her, because she is now part of me. We are one. She's part of my body. When she had the breast cancer, I took off, didn't move, didn't travel for 1 year. I stood by her bed. Every time she opened her eyes from chemo, she looked over the chair, and there was her husband standing over her, praying for her, demanding God take care of her. And that's love. That's being in love. I wasn't going to give my life for her in a bus stop, but I sure enough give it for her today.
Oh, man. We got a few moments left with Dr. Clarence Mason Weaver. Amen. Apostle, any last questions, sir, or comments? This is powerful.
No, you're absolutely right, Dr. Weaver. I remember when I first met my wife, you know, in 2 weeks, I was ready to marry.
Brother,
and here we are 34 years later. at first she said I was infatuated, this and that, until her grandmother prophesied it.
Yeah.
And she still didn't want to believe it then. But
we know the difference. You know, we know the difference, brother.
The Spirit of God in you lets you know and say, that's her.
Right,
that's
there.
Him.
There she
you
is.
Know? And that's where the connection begins and you build on it.
Now, she's going to be stubborn. My wife did not give me her name for 2 weeks, and then she left the bus stop. I literally had to look for her 2.5 years when I found her again. And first thing I said, thought you got away, didn't you, girl? You didn't get away. Come here. Get in the car. No, sir.
Oh, my God.
I understand,
oh
brother.
I tell you. Dr. Weaver, I'm telling you, you can't leave us. You cannot leave us. You got to come back, Dr. Weaver, and we're going to contact Mrs. Weaver, amen, to reschedule you, because what you have is a well of knowledge, of wisdom, of insight. And I want to thank you, man of God, for taking time out of your busy schedule to be with Apostle Carlos Rosa here on Global Spiritual Revolution Radio. We love you in Jesus' name.
Appreciate it, brother. Take care of yourself. My wife loves my schedule more than I do, so contact her. I appreciate it, guys.
You guys, we love you, man of God, and forgive us, amen, that you couldn't hear us when you came on. Forgive me, that was my fault. And to all of our Global Revolution partners, we love you in Jesus' mighty name. And I want to also announce, like I said earlier in the broadcast, we're moving to a larger studio, amen, and that is the Third Day Studio, amen. Again, beloved, that is the Third Day or Day 3 Broadcasting Company. We are in connection with the studio in Long Island, New York, the Day 3 Broadcasting Company. We're going to another level, Saints of God, and I will talk to you more about that in the coming weeks to come. Amen. In the coming days to come. And we're excited. We are nationally syndicated throughout the United States, also throughout around the world, and now 100, praise God, and 75 nations. By the grace of the Lord, we are growing at a rate that it's blowing our minds. So I want to thank Apostle Carlos Rosa for being with us. He is our co-host. Thank you, Apostle, for covering us spiritually and apostolically. Thank you, Apostle Angela, for covering us spiritually and apostolically. I want to thank Apostle Cindy Jacobs. Amen. God willing, she'll be back with us. Amen. Sometime in the near future. Amen. And also thank you, Dr. Clarence Mason Weaver, for being with us. He'll be back with us, God willing, in the near future. I want to also announce, as we're moving into our new studios, the first Tuesday of next month, the Day 3 Broadcasting Company Studios. Praise God. We are excited there in Massapequa, Long Island, New York. God is expanding the ministry. And I want to thank all of you for your prayers, for your support, and for us fulfilling the prophecy that Apostle Jacobs just said about us now connecting on another level. We have a much bigger and larger audience. And I want to thank, again, Apostle Rosa, Carlos Rosa, for being our co-host who has taken us to another level. I want to announce also that this coming Thursday, we're going to have Dr. Tex Mars with us. Now, I want to apologize to the Global Revolution family. Now, it was on last Thursday he was scheduled to be with us, but I forgot in my humanity I was supposed to call him into the broadcast, but yet I was waiting on him to call. So I apologize to all of you Global Revolution partners who were waiting on Dr. Tex Mars. He will be with us, God willing, this coming Thursday, and we're going to be calling him, patching him into the studio here in New York City. I want to thank all of you. He'll be back again Thursday here on Global Spiritual Revolution Radio. And I also want to announce, praise God, that on April the 7th, we will have former CIA operative Dr. Robert David Steele, who will be with us. Now, he was scheduled to be with us this past Monday, but had to reschedule for the 7th of April. And that's going to be on a Friday, all right? And he's coming in from Norway, and we're going to be interviewing him by phone. Amen. And we're going to be talking about the history in the schematical structure of the deep state, all right? And here on Global Spiritual Revolution Radio, he'll be with us on the 7th. Praise God. And also on April the 11th, amen, on April the 11th, we will have with us for the very first time here on Global Spiritual Revolution Radio, Dr. David Wayne. He is the author of the Genesis 6 Conspiracy. Dr. David Wayne is the author of the Genesis 6 Conspiracy. He is going to break this down for us on the 11th of April, amen, 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time here on Global Spiritual Revolution Radio. Dr. David Wayne will be with us, amen. He is the author, again, of the Genesis 6 Conspiracy, and he's going to explain to us how that demonic bloodline, and we talked about this, I believe, on last week, Apostle, that bloodline has been passed down to certain people in different continents and different nations around the world, specifically those in the Middle East. So he'll be with us. Dr. David Wayne will be with us on the 11th of April. And also, I'm going to hold off on announcing who will be with us on next Tuesday. We need to get confirmation. A well-known prophet, a well-known woman of God. I'm not going to say her name until we get a confirmation that she'll be with us on the 28th of March, next Tuesday. All right? So God bless you. We love you in the Lord. We'll see you Thursday at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time with Dr. Tex Mars. He'll be back with us. He is the president of the Power of Prophecy there in Austin, Texas. Amen. And we're going to continue to talk about, amen, not just remaking America in the image of God, but we're going to be discussing his brand new book, Robot Alchemy, how the federal government, all right, how DARPA and the agency called ARPA is, their plan is to destroy humanity. So Dr. Mars, who is way more qualified than we are, he will be with us on Thursday. Spread the word about Global Spiritual Revolution Radio. We are growing at a fever pitch, and it is because that this, as Apostle Jacob said, this is God. This is the perfect will of God in Christ Jesus concerning us. Thank you all. I love you all. In Jesus' name, we're going to be posting the podcast of tonight's broadcast on both Facebook and Twitter within the next hour. Amen. And we're going to be also broadcasting our broadcast, our podcast on Red Nation Rising Radio there in Dallas, Texas. Amen. Alongside some very powerful conservative talk show hosts, Sean Hannity, Rush Limbaugh. And I thank God that Apostle Carlos and I have been favored and graced by God to be a part of that radio nation there in Dallas, Texas. Also, we are going to be broadcasting not just for them, 10 a.m. on Sunday mornings. We're going to be replaying a lot of podcasts that we've had in previous weeks on Red Nation Rising Radio every Sunday morning at 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, and also on every Sunday night from 7 p.m. to 9 p.m., we're going to be, it won't be a live broadcast, but we're going to be putting past guests, past podcasts, past broadcasts on live talk stream live radio. Again, talkstreamliveradio.com every Sunday night, God willing, 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. here on Global Spiritual Revolution Radio. And I thank God that beginning April the 4th, amen, we're going to be moving into the Day 3 Broadcasting Studio Company there in Massapequa, Long Island, New York. Amen. Thank you all for your prayers, and we'll see you on Thursday, 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time with Dr. Tex Mars, all the way from Austin, Texas. Spread the word. Spread the word. He will be with us on Thursday, 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time here on Global Spiritual Revolution Radio. Have a great night, everybody. We love you in the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. For we are raising the consciousness of mankind to become the consciousness of Jesus Christ. We see you on Thursday here on Global Spiritual Revolution Radio. Thank you.
Thank you.